Good day. Hi, good day. I believe we've been wonderful. We've all been looking good today. Everything has gone on well. As today's church service to those of us who went to church today and those that are not working today. I want to say good day to you, and you're welcome to today's edition of Building Plans and Building Construction. Right now, today, we'll be discussing about what you need to do, after you bought your land. Like I mentioned on this forum, please don't get me wrong, I was on air yesterday briefly to test my other specialty. I'm a football commentator as well. Unfortunately, it did not go out well. It was just the image, because some of my fans thought I came on air for building construction discussion. But no, there's two things I want, because I'm turning this channel to a proper TV channel. But because we don't have content at the moment, I've got to make do with what I have. Okay, so that's why majority of the discussion I'm having is on building construction. However, I'll be coming on air from time to time, weekends, especially when we have some vital matches which our fans will be interested in. This is a proper channel which I want to turn to a variety of programs. But at the moment, what is taking its center stage is the building construction and football. Will be having if you look at it, what I did yesterday wasn't much importance, but I got 5,000 people, over 5,000 people were able to watch, were attracted to what I did yesterday. So welcome guys for coming today's show. Basically, I want to be talking more today on what I started last Sunday. You remember when I said when you purchase a land, you are going to do a survey, which I mentioned survey last Sunday. Okay, let me bring you to, I'm going to come a little bit on this. Bear with me. I'm trying to get the image right. Bear with me. Okay, right. Okay, right. Basically, before you draw the building plan, okay, once again, let me welcome you guys. Hello, Stanley. Oh, thank you. Thank you, Stanley. I appreciate you. I thank you for the encouragement. Right, what I am trying to do today is to build on the last week show. Okay, I'm trying to build on last week's show. You remember I mentioned something to do with when you purchase your land, you're going to after you purchase the land, you're going to the survey. Now I did show the survey last Sunday. Sorry, this thing is flipping. Let me go back to that. Bear with me. I'm going to go back to that. Sorry, woman. I just need to adjust the system. Sorry that I'm flicking back and front. So, like I said, last Sunday I mentioned that when you buy your land, if you're just coming to the construction industry, obviously you're going to purchase a land. Somebody's going to help you to buy land. And after buying it, then you do your survey. Okay, right. No, no. You do your survey, right? Remember I said you buy this, you do the survey depending on the location of the place where you're purchasing the land from. A survey starts from average of 100 to 150,000. If you see somebody who's saying that's going to do a survey for you for 50,000 naira, they are trying to fob you. They're going to run away with your money. Okay, right. You remember I mentioned the genuity and what you should look out for in the survey when they are trying to do survey for you. You remember I mentioned there's an emblem, a seal of approval from a chartered surveyor. A surveyor don't have to be a chartered surveyor. A surveyor goes to the land and bring their equipment and do whatever measurement, length and breadth, height, whatever, length and breadth and width or whatever. But when the final report comes out, it comes out in this format, okay? It's got, you could see that I've blotted for Data Protection Act, I've blotted the names and address of that property. The owner wouldn't want us to disclose certain things of that. Now, if you look at that round image, in the mid at the bottom middle bottom of that survey, that is to tell you the genuinity and the genuineness of the survey report. A cheap surveyor will not quickly go and make this because it will cost them a lot of money to do that. It will certainly cost them a lot of money to do this survey of the seal of approval. The seal of approval is attached and sealed by a chartered surveyor. They pay them some fee to make it to be, because a chartered surveyor will not put their own seal if they don't know, if they don't trust the surveyor who is bringing this, if they're not going to submit this survey report to the local government of where the land is located. Obviously, like I said, you got to be sure that when they are giving you the survey, when you are doing the survey report, make sure you emphasize that I would like to see, I want a survey report that has a seal of approval. It doesn't have to be a red seal. Like I said, I told you, it's an emboss. It's like an emboss, okay? Let me show you the image again. It's like an emboss. Okay, that's a survey there. Unfortunately, I couldn't. This is one of those, like the one I showed you last Saturday, last Sunday, is one of those that don't have red seal. But obviously, it doesn't have to have red seal, but it will have a seal, like something like a compressed embossed, raised. Okay, so that is that. So, like I said, if you get that, obviously you won't. That's the mark. That red mark in the middle indicates the land of where the property, the land out of various lands that are in the area. That is that square as earmarked and identify your own portion of land. It's as identify your own portion of land. Okay, right. So let's move on. Okay, so when you do the building plan, this is one of the plans that you do, which obviously will come in this will come in this format. So when you do the survey, the plan is coming like this. Your architect designs something for you. Obviously, we mention that all this needs to be done. When all is done, we need to I'm talking of Lagos State now. What you need to do a building plan to be approved, obviously, please, if you're buying land in Lagos, this is very, very important to those of us that are so familiar, that really want to buy land in Lagos Island, in Lekki, in Gbagada, name those mainland or any. It is a a regulation that your building plan must be approved. It is very important. It is part of the procedure of Lagos State Government. I don't know of other state government. I'm so much of the Lagos State Government. It is part of the procedure and that your plan must be approved before you start your construction. Please don't spend money twice. Right, it does take a while. Sometimes it takes about 6 months, sometimes it takes about a year before they approve your building plan. Okay, I'm going to explain to you that obviously that's why some people are running away from Lagos. They're running away from Lagos because they want to start their construction ASAP. You can't be abroad and let something else be wasting your time. You wouldn't have raised so much money and work hard in the snow and work hard during the difficult times. You don't sleep, your family is sleeping, and you are working your backside out there. It's not easy. Maybe in Nigeria, people do businesses and raise money elsewhere, but the one and only job which you do, which you are using it to feed your family, and out of this, you are able to earmark or set aside some money. You can't afford to get this happen to you. If you are buying a land in Lagos, you have to make sure that you follow the procedure and the process. Right, if you don't, you're going to get your fingers burnt. You're not going to get the appreciable result you want, because the sooner immediately you buy your land, you did the survey, you did the building plan, and you start construction immediately, you're going to get your house. Because this your neighbors might even be an agent for the state government. Right, they report straight away to the local government and say somebody has started building in beside me. And if your neighbor gets to know that you are from abroad, then you have started your trouble. Right now, the moment you start building, the construction, and you have not told, the local government has not known that the place has been registered or approved, they send their agent straight. The local government officials will go there and mark the building X, the building red. They're going to mark it red, and that is the beginning of your trouble. You will be spending together. In fact, it's an understatement if they mark your house. It will be an understatement. What they normally do, they even get some idiots that they never like good thing. They would break some walls, they would demolish some aspects of that property, they will smash it down. They're not minding the amount you have spent to that stage. They are going to smash that place down. You won't have a property. You wouldn't have worked hard, raised the money, and let some hoodlums or some idiots in the local government, because the plan has not been approved, they come and smash the building down. So before they will not begin to drag the matter. They are not going to approve that building plan on time. They will be extorting you. They will be asking for money today. They will be asking for money tomorrow. They will be asking for money because, and more so if they know that you are from abroad, they will be asking and asking and asking. So, my brothers and sisters, if you are going to build a house in Lagos, you got to follow the rules. You got to follow the guidelines. You got to follow the procedures. And one of the procedures is that you will need to do your survey. After the survey, submit it to the chartered surveyor, submit it to the local government. It's going to be looked at. Then you submit your building plan. Your building plan that is already been done with AutoCAD, not just a draftsman drawing. You submit the building plan, which I've shown on the image there. Then you will four copies to them. Then you will, let me read some of the things that you will need to get ready before your building plan is surveyed. Okay, I'm going to read this to you. If you have finally gotten that land in your dream location, This is only the beginning. What is the next step in getting the building erected? Processing a building plan for erecting a structure is the most absolute next step. Erecting a building on a piece of land or a large expanse of land without a building plan approval can be likened to running a country without any law guiding it. Building plans are the first substantial thing that depicts picture of the buildings you will wish to build. They are geographical representation of what a building will look like after construction, and they also help in the process of evaluating the cost of erecting such a structure. In most countries, it is customary to obtain a permit or approval from appropriate authorities before making any structure. And in Nigeria, in Lagos, or any other some other states, urban states, is not exception. All in all, a building plan approval is necessary before you start your building construction, or before your building construction can start. Without it, you cannot adequately grasp the reality that 6-bedroom duplex with a swimming pool, bear with me. I guess I could give you the image of your dream. That's a ground floor area view of some of the building plans, which are like the drawings. Okay, right. So something like this before any of the dream house. Okay. Bedroom with a swimming pool and a lovely garden, or on 100 square meter full of convenience store, meeting the needs of various individuals. A building plan approval ensures that the building complies with the building laws, codes, and codes of the states of those of the urban states. It prevents people from erecting structures as they like some states. I'm not going to mention this state because it's a public forum. You can buy a land today and start the building construction tomorrow. Okay. The first thing to do when you want to begin to start your construction of any structure, especially in Lagos, is to obtain a development permit from the state government. The office in charge of state physical planning or development authority, LASDPA, that's for the Lagos area. Okay, a parastatal under the Ministry of Lands and Physical Planning. However, getting a building plan approval is not very easy process. That is why most landlords forgo this very essential and delicate aspect of building construction and home ownership. There will be, let's see how many people are on this forum now. Just bear with me. Okay. Oh, thank you. Stanley, how are you? Thank you very much. I think I've greeted you before. Hi, guys. Please bring your question. If you have any question today, let's tackle it. We are all hustlers, and hustlers should not make mistakes. Hustlers have gone out there to break the barriers, to break the difficult aspect of things. You've broken the difficult, barrier by crossing from Nigeria 3,000 miles. For those of you who are in UK, you've crossed that barrier. To those of you who are in Europe, in Italy, in Spain, any part of Europe that you are, or you are in Asia, right? You've crossed that barrier, right? Okay, let's do things right. Let's put it this way. Wherever location you find yourself, we are hustlers. I am a hustler. You are a hustler. And hustlers think big. They think great. They think positive. They think intelligently. They are forward thinking. They don't. We all make mistakes. But if you can hustle to travel 3,000 miles to UK, and you manage to get your visa, you get your stay well, you get your stay, you get immigration, you don't have any, you got permanent residency of whatever country you are, that's a peace of mind, you are a hustler. And then for whatever job, you're working in office, you're doing business, you're working in the factory, doing one thing or the other, you are a hustler. Because if you and I are hustler, that's why we're not back, we're not in Nigeria. And we are part of the process of our hustling is we help auntie, we help uncle, we help children, we help aunt, name them everywhere. And part of the process of the hustling is to build this good and lovely house. All right? And part of the hustling proceeds that you have, this is a kind of computer email, you want to transform. You want to take some of these proceeds back to build some of these houses. This is a lovely one. A hustler think big. You can't go back there and let them be dictating and be giving you one silly design or one silly buy cheap roof, buy cheap windows, or buy cheap something to build your house. Now, like I said, one of the shows that we have in the modern era now, nobody puts waste pipe hanging on the wall. Waste pipe now is buried in the part of the construction foundation of lovely houses. Like, you can't have a building, a beautiful house like this, and then you begin to have, you want to park your car, and then the gully for the soakaway is obstructing your parking. Soakaway is already coming up from the floor, and water is flushing, and this and that. No. Hustlers don't think like that. They think beautiful like this. They think big. When hustlers want to do things, because they take their time to do good things, right? Hustlers, we are all hustlers, okay? We are thinking big. So, like I said, Lagos State and some other urban cities, they have come with these ideas. Yeah, hi Kazim. It's good. Thank you, Kazim. I just see you. Thank you. How are you? How is Canada? Are you at work? Hi Kazim. Yeah, right. Thank you. So, like I said, hustlers in Canada, in US, in Europe, in Asia, in Singapore, in Malaysia, we are all hustlers. You can't hustle and make it work during the winter, and most time that other people are sleeping, you are working, and then you want to build a house, and they're giving you one silly thing. That's why this forum is all about. Let's share ideas, right? Let's share ideas. What is the modern technology? Do you want to import your tiles? Do you want to get your switch and your dimmer light from Europe or from where? Right, you've got to be very careful. So don't let those hoodlums dictate to you out there, right? So, like I said, Lagos State and other states are into all these corrective measures, because there is so much, they need to check everything so that the houses are not collapsing in the next couple of weeks or couple of months once it's finally done. Right, in getting the building plan approval is to be erected. First and foremost, you have a certificate, you have a COO, what is called certificate of occupancy. Lagos State are doing that. Now, people don't do that, they start erecting building, but they start knocking their buildings down. And then for you to get that thing, the construction, they will force you to make sure that you get the COO before your building plan can continue. All right. Even they assess the appropriate bodies. Also, your land title is a major department in deciding the height, the density of your structure, depending on the area the building is to be situated or the kind of building you intend to put up. All right. On this account, the following are some of the documents that must be submitted when applying for building plan approval in line with Lagos State or some urban cities. Operation 3030, an acronym for speedy processing and approval of building plan application. Okay, right. I've mentioned the 5 sets of each architectural drawings. Right, 5 copies of architectural drawings, the building plan. You have to submit the 5 copies of this. There will be. Let me see who are on this forum now before I continue. Yeah. Oh, right. There will be. We've got 5 people at the moment. Right. So 5 copies of the drawings, structural drawings with detailing the calculation and letter of structural stability from certified engineer. You need 5 copies of survey. You need the title documents. You need tax clearance and government fee in case of individuals. The government fee only comes to play after your building plan must have been assessed and marked for approval. Then certified true copy of certificate of occupancy, title document, confirmation letter from land in lieu of consent, if applicable, clearance letter from LUAC, I don't know what that one is, clearance letter from housing, fire, transportation, and drainage, copy of confirmation letter from NTDA, I don't know where these are, copy of demand notice for current year ground rent, hey, and applicable evidence payment of ground rent, soil test report. Lagos State and some of these urban city have gone environmental impact analysis report and tenement rate receipt. Okay, usual delays is getting a building plan approval stem from tax and structural drawing papers as well as loopholes in tax papers. It is therefore advisable that you get familiar in advance with the required document, as some of these will take some time to obtain, and make sure your tax papers are up to date. Also, getting the final approval usually varies with different construction sizes. However, you can simply employ the service of an architect, surveyor, or any other knowledgeable member of your building team to process your building plan approval on your behalf. Okay, right. Guys, looking at this, let me get my face onto the screen. Right, I have read there's so much bottlenecks. That is why people are running away from Lagos State. There's so much long protocol process before you can get your building approved to be constructed. That's why people are buying their lands in Ogun State, in Arepo, in Wawa, in Banku, in Ofada, in in Sagamu, in just name it, anywhere that is not Lagos State, because this one will frustrate you. All the things I've mentioned so far are generally official issues that will frustrate, especially people from abroad. If they know that you're from abroad, not only from abroad, they purposely delay it so that you can put money down and get it speedy. And even putting money down doesn't necessarily make it to be fast. But you and I are hustlers and we don't have time. Hustlers don't wait for protocols. Hustlers wants to get business done. Hustlers wants to buy the land today. But if it's possible, They want to start the building construction today. Hustlers are always impatient, and that's why we get results. We hustlers don't wait. We do nice good things, but we don't want delays. You and I know that abroad, when you are abroad, things are done pretty fast. Nothing delays things. Once you are ready, because everything's already in motion, plans, everything. So the layout is done, the roads is there, the network is there. So you just want to get down to business. So hustlers don't waste time. So I want to advise you this today, that if you really want to start something, forget about Lagos. Because you can buy the land today and take you 1 year, take 2 years before you start. By the time you start, you have already lost interest in the whole project. Because say for example, now you buy land, you're feeling great. You want to buy that land. You woke up. You say, "Hello, what is wrong?" The beginning of the year, I've not done anything. This is November. I've got 1 month left for the year, which you can still. There's nothing. It's not too late. You can start something. And then you woke up and say, "Well, I've got this money. I want to quickly run with it. I've got this idea from the internet. I want to run with it." And then you start. You do the building plan, and then it takes 6 months, 7 months. Who knows what will happen within that 6 months? Who knows what will happen within that 1 year? You might lose interest after 6 months, after 3 months. You want to start it right there and then. That's why a hustler, they don't wait for nobody. That's why we work, that's why we are abroad. We don't have time for all these long, long protocols. So that's why we are abroad. That's why we're here. We are all hustlers. Hustlers think fast. They think ahead. They already think in 2019. Hustlers already thinking of what are they going to do in 2019. Yeah, it's good. Thank you. My weekend has been good. Right. Hustlers already, their dreams, they already plan what they want to do it by March. By March, they want to build the house to window level. By March, they want to do the roof. By March, they want to do the plastering. By November, by June, they already want to get tenants into the house. By December, the first tenant has already finished the first year rent. They want to get things going. So I will not advise you to start thinking of buying. Number one, the land is expensive in Lagos. Number two, they take long protocols before your building plan starts. So yeah, keep the question coming. Yeah, that's what I'm saying. A lot of us that are dreaming to start a project, I will not advise you to start to do something in Lagos. If you have time, maybe you're one of those that have plenty of time, they want to wait. Well, I don't have time to wait. I really don't have time to wait at all. So you want to start something right away, you have to think of another state. And I would suggest Ogun seems to be the nearest one that you can get average of 600,000 naira to start something in Lagos. Okay, so if you want to build your own dream house and you want to start immediately, you don't want anything to obstruct you or block your chances of starting something, I will advise you, think elsewhere, look elsewhere, and forget about Lagos. I'm trying to look at the text I got from somebody was saying that how much is an average land in Ogun. Okay, depending on the side of Ogun that you are, I'm just trying to check the, bear with me, I need to read what the person is writing properly. Just bear with me, just 1 second. Right. How much is the average of land in Ogun? Yes, there are quite different prices, starting from 600,000. The one that we asked them to go and check for us, the cheaper one that we told them to go and check for us, is not right. It's about 35 to 40 minutes to Lagos. That's not too bad. It's not as far as Ibadan, but it's about 35 to 40 minutes to Lagos. So if you are intending to start something slowly, right, this is a recommendation for you. You can start it slowly, and you can get to the dream of your house. If you're talking about security, you can put alarm, you can put CCTV, you can put solar panel. Now, let me even tell you, Nigeria has gone wonderfully. Nigeria is growing. Now, your borehole is powered by solar. You are a hustler. You are in Europe. You are in Asia. You are in outside. You are outside Nigeria. You can package package a solar system, the solar cell, and ship it to Lagos, and they will connect it. They will connect it for your borehole, and they will supply you water even when there's no light. You will pull water from the borehole into the tank. So Nigeria, there is so much energy in Nigeria. Not like when they take the light. No noisy generator. You don't need generator to even power a bowl into a tank. So there are so many things that you guys can dream of. We are running to 2019. Make a quality decision. January to now. I know some of us are making frantic and positive plans, but because of commitment here and there, commitment of supporting the auntie's brother, uncle's daughter, uncle's son, yeah, you have looked after these people enough. Now 2019 is your own year. You can start something right away. Right, these are good dreams, house. It can be built anywhere. Right, you can start something right away. Not too long. You can start something. You are able to do it. You look at the energy. Let me put it this way. Before you came abroad, that zeal, that energy, that burning energy, the desire that you want to make it, right? You have slowed down. You got to think of the way you started when you landed, wherever location you are abroad. Come to think of it, that the kind of plans that you have in your head, the kind of the resilience, the capacity of energy that was in you that make you to get that visa, to make you to get that stay, that kind of curiosity. That you want to do 4 or 5 jobs that you can move mountain. You know, that kind of zeal, that kind of purpose, tenacity, that drive, that drive that you have that makes you to go and get your visa, that makes you to work on your stay, that makes you to work on the job that you get. So that same drive, where is it now? Where is the drive? You're going to look at yourself and say, no, oh boy, oh girl, I have slowed down. This is not real me. This is not real you. This is not me. I am more than this. I can do all things. I am better than this. I have the drive in me. Where is that old drive? I want that drive again. I want to use that drive to launch into 2019. Right. I've looked back and I've not been. I don't like what I'm doing. I don't like what is happening. I don't like things that are happening around me. I've been here too long. I've stayed 10 years, 15 years, 20 years, 30 years. I've got nothing to show for it. It's not too late, my brother. It's not too late. There's no time that is too late. There's no time that is too late. All one needs to do is to realize and say, wait a minute. What have I been doing here? I've been long enough. Even people that I left back home, they are making it. They are doing it. They are pressing forward. So all you need to do is to look back and look at the energy that was in you before you left Nigeria. That zeal, that drive that you had, that made you to pursue your stay, that made you to that galvanize you, that you are day in, day out, you are there, you are all in the front line, wherever location you are, in Asia, in Singapore, in Malaysia, right? What that drive, you can do it. It's not difficult. It is, you just need to look at the prodigal child came to realize by himself and say, you know what, I can. Some of us, I'm a graduate now. How many of my colleagues are doing this back home? Now I can do better than this. I really can do better than this.
I can do better than this. I can really, really do better than this. You know what? I can do better than this. That's what you're going to, that capacity of strength that you are going to use to kick your backside and say, you know what? You know what? How many of us are living in this kind of house here? I will jump out in the sun, in the winter, in the snow, and I will still come back to come and meet my family. Some people, some family have already been already gone to bed before they even come back from work. So you're going to look at it and say, you know what? I am going to this 2019 that I'm going. I am going to make something from what only information I get online. It's not too late. Okay. I'm not going to stay long today. All you need to do is that please, if you have any queries, don't forget to contact people that are experts in those areas. Search online, try and compare prices. Go to ganjua.com, go to any of the website. They can definitely, you can learn a lot from this. And not even that, you can save. People quickly put something aside. You see, let me be honest with you. There's one analogy I normally know. When you are pouring water into a bottle, and that bottle does bottle, when the bottle is full, there's no place where you can put that extra water. But if that bottle is leaking a little bit, as you are pouring water into it, water will never fill it. That means you can produce and make a lot of things from money you put into something. See, start by procuring a land. Just get one land. I've said it before. Nigeria is a place where you buy something today, you want to sell it tomorrow, you are not going to sell it the same price. Nigeria is a place where you invest today, in the next 6 months, it is not the same money you're going to buy. Land is an example of it. Building property is an example of it. From time immemorial, from years in the past, there's always a landlord, there's always a tenant. So you choose. Do you want to go back to Nigeria and realize that all the mates that you have left behind, they have made it, they have built houses, they have built mansions. So start. We're going to 2019. Nobody is forcing you, but we're trying to encourage you. This is a forum that encourages people. This is a forum that lifts people's spirits high. This is a forum that wakes people from their slumber. This is a forum that makes people realize how resilient they are. This is a forum that makes people to realize that they are very energetic, and that energy that makes them to cross over abroad, that makes them to work out and get that papers sorted out, that same energy, you can still use it to build and create something back home in Nigeria. All right? Nigeria is a place where even UK government is planning to invest because they saw something good in that country. So how can you and I sit on the fence and be watching other people investing in our country? So I'm going to stop today. I give you 1-2 minutes to get questions and answers. So please, I want this forum to be as popular as possible. Please, if you have not subscribe to this forum. Subscribe and let this forum be a success. Let it be known worldwide. Let it go viral. Okay? Right. And if God lays something in your heart to bless this forum, if you want to bless us, well, just my number is there. Tell me what you want or what you want to do for me to be able to get more information across to you and to us, and for us to make it and go home and be what people are looking at us that we are. God will make us to make it, because we are all ambassadors. We are straight. We are good ambassadors. We are not bad ambassadors. Ambassador of your family, a frontliner of Nigeria. We are doing very well wherever location we are. So this is a good image, a good property that you want to go back home, like you're going on holiday and rest in it. All right? Okay. So I'm going to stop right now. I'm expecting 1 or 2 questions. All right? Please bring your questions to the forum. I've got 1 or 2 minutes more. Today has been a wonderful one. I have mentioned it last Sunday. Please, anytime I come online, it's either I come online, if it is not Sunday broadcast, if it is early on Saturday or sometimes early on Sunday, it is me doing a football commentary of certain football matches. So, but you will see me online. So, but when you look at it and you know what I'm discussing is about football, it is just, it's me. But I will keep on this forum. I will continue to bring up-to-date information on construction. And the time for the construction is from 7 upward on Sundays. That this time is a regular slot. But any other time I come online that is not 7 o'clock upward on Sunday, it is a football information. And those of us who love football, who love Premiership, who love something that we can talk about football, you can come along as well and be part of it. All right. On this note, I want to say, please be your best in what you need to do. Continue to be resilient. Continue to be dynamic. Continue to be dreaming big. We will together succeed in Jesus' name. We will not, as the year is coming to an end, there will not be any disaster in our family. We will continue to do very well as God has been behind us in whatever we do. Those of us that are yet to regularize our papers in the countries where we are, God has proposed that you're going to be in that country, we perfect everything. On this note today, I want to say thank you for all the contributors and for the contributions, all the well wishers, all the good commendation. Please, I love you and I appreciate you for coming, taking your time to come on this show. On this note, I want to say, we are going into winter in Europe. Winter has already started in some places in America, in Canada, in Asia. Please wrap up well. It is not the will of God for a man to die, but to come to look after himself. We'll be hearing good news about you, good report, a nice report that you are succeeding, you're changing business, you're changing jobs, and your business is doing very well. So until I see you next Sunday, or until you hear me again on this forum, this is your regular host, Mr. Larry Doon. Thank you very much, and God bless you all. Have a wonderful week ahead of, okay? See you next time. All right? Thank you, and God bless you. Thank you. Right, I draw the curtain off. Thank you very much. Thank you once again. And thank you for coming on the show. Let me just show you those images one by one again. Right? We want to do one of good things like this. Right? It is the will of God for us. We're not going to perish. We're hardworking people that left Nigeria to better and improve our lives. And to God be the glory, we're going to get one of these, and we will do it properly. We will not be swindled. To avoid being swindled, please contact people like us. You don't have to give me any contract, but we will advise you. Posterity will judge that we're doing a good thing here. I'm just reversing all those pictures to give you a reminder. All right, okay, all right. So have a wonderful week. I draw the curtain on today's show. Thank you, and God bless you all. All right, thank you. Bye bye.